We live in a digital era where technology enables new exciting scenarios that were previously only possible in science fiction books. This presentation, digital presentation, is an example of such scenario. Unfortunately, with great technological progress comes the downside of security risks. If you are following security press, there are no platforms that cannot be hacked. I'm Helen Alas, Principal Program Manager, partnering today with Kanishk Srivastav.
Hello, everyone. So glad to be here.
Kanishk and I, we're here today to share with you the latest cross-platform advancements for Microsoft Defender ATP for Endpoint. But most importantly, we're here today to remind you to develop strategies to protect full range of platforms present in your environment. Now get comfortable and let's get started.
To echo our opening remark that no operating system is secure, here are just a few relevant statistics. Every year brings new malware and new, potentially unwanted applications. And this year is not an exception, especially given the increased need for remote work arrangements. If you look at top 5 malware categories, they're comparable across all three platforms, with a notable expected difference of lower poor rates on Linux compared to Mac and Android. Expansion of Microsoft Defender for Endpoint to non-Windows platforms officially started in 2019 by extending support to macOS. Initial scope of our macOS offering was focused on preventive AV functionality. EDR for Mac was added 6 months later in December. The next major milestone in our cross-platform journey happened in June of this calendar year 2020, when we announced general availability of our offering for Linux servers. Following very similar release sequence as for macOS, the initial Linux scope is focused on preventive AV functionality. EDR for Linux is now in active development. Today is a special day for us. We're thrilled to share more exciting news about Android and iOS platforms. Kanishk will go into details of our mobile threat defense in the second half of our presentation. With all the latest cross-platform advancements, Microsoft Defender for Endpoint Security Center becomes a truly unified portal for security operations. Now having Windows, Mac, Linux, and mobile platforms in the same unified portal gives our customers an option to reduce number of security solutions needed to protect full range of platforms and devices in their heterogeneous environments. We are on a journey. Many of our recent wins have been accomplished in partnerships with our customers. These partnerships have been instrumental to defining our strategy as we iterate on our cross-platform investments. We sincerely thank to all our partners for continuous support and input. And now, let's zoom into most recent developments for macOS. Following Apple's strategy to move away from kernel extensions to system extensions on macOS, Microsoft Defender for Endpoint is also moving to system extensions. Full switch to new system extensions is expected around general availability date of macOS 11. In the meantime, the new implementation of our agent is available for Catalina devices that are registered for InsiderFast Microsoft at Update RIN. We highly encourage you to try the new system extensions-based implementation on your Catalina devices and try it prior macOS 11 GA date to ensure that your environments are ready and properly configured. Such proper configuration will enable seamless to the end user switch of our Defender agent to system extensions immediately after upgrade to macOS 11 Big Sur. We are also excited to bring threat and vulnerability management capabilities to macOS. Both vulnerability assessment and security recommendations for Mac will become an integral part of Microsoft Defender for Endpoint offering. You can learn more about Mac TVM in a session, Modernized Risk Management with the latest threat and vulnerability management capabilities. Additional features in the pipeline for macOS include category of web protection functionalities, which consists from web threat protection, custom URL allow block indicators, Microsoft Cloud App Security, and web content filtering. Additionally, we are working to bring a USB storage device control and tamper protection. For all these functionalities, You will get on-device experience as well as alerts in Microsoft Defender for Endpoint Security Center. We are continuously working to enrich our selection of post-breach detections for Mac, and we're also excited to share that we are actively working to bring you EDR response for macOS. We are happy to mention recent advancements released by Microsoft Endpoint Manager that improve deployment of Microsoft Defender for Endpoint solution on macOS. These advancements also simplify configuration experience by providing familiar and intuitive built-in configuration controls. Now, let's dive into Linux updates. Our Linux server offering went into general availability in June of this calendar year 2020. The initial release supports 6 most common Linux server distributions, typically last 2-3 versions, and it can be deployed via Puppet, Ansible, or using your existing Linux configuration management tool. From functional perspective, our initial version delivers full preventive AV functionality, where you can accomplish your typical AV-related tasks via convenient command-line interface. Basic alert and machine information are available in Microsoft Defender for Endpoint Security Center as a starting point for your Linux monitoring. Our Linux story will soon be extended by EDR capabilities and threat and vulnerability management for Linux. The upcoming iteration of EDR investments will bring rich post-breach detections coverage and flexible advanced hunting capabilities. With threat and vulnerability management for Linux, you will benefit from cross-platform parity in vulnerability assessment and security recommendations.
For the next set of exciting news about mobile threat defense, I'm passing controls to Kanishk.
Thank you, Helen. Hi again, everyone. I'm Kanishk Vastav, lead PM for our mobile threat defense offering, that is Android and iOS endpoint applications. So I'll start off with the big announcement that our Android offering is now in GA. And iOS is now getting to public preview. So go out there and try out our offering. So let's start with why mobile threat defense. We all know that the productivity has gone mobile and our corporate data is being increasingly accessed from outside the perimeter using the mobile devices. And COVID has only increased this trend. Now, attackers are one of the smartest folks around. They go where the users are, and on mobile devices, it gives them a great opportunity because the security is lax. A good example here is the huge jump in phishing attacks on mobile, and all this has resulted in the security concerns being the number one reason why enterprises are hesitant in adopting BYOD. And finally, it is really important to understand that MDM and MAM are just management tools. They will not protect your organization from cybersecurity threats. Only an MTD can do that. So when we look at the threat landscape for mobile, the first thing that pops up is that phishing is the most important threat vector. And most interestingly, 85% of these attacks happen outside of email. Coming to malware, which is critical on Android, not as much on iOS, because of the stricter checks and policies on the platform. And finally, jailbroken and rooted devices, which are less common, but the severity is high and hence it's important.
Here's the Microsoft Defender for Endpoint Android app, where we are demoing malware protection.
We start with our user in Google Play Store, about to download a malicious test app. And we see that the Defender has raised a notification. User can see the details associated with the malware in Defender. Now over to the SecOps view, where in Security Center, the SecOps can see the details associated with the attack. Now this information is also passed to Intune, which can then kick in conditional access. Now, when the user tries to open Outlook on her device, she finds that her email access is blocked. What she can do now is go to the Defender app and uninstall the malware. This marks the device as clean. This info is also passed to ATP console, and the device is marked as compliant. So now when she accesses her email, she finds that it is no longer blocked.
So now let's come to what's the offering on Android. The first thing that we'll start with is web protection. And the primary thing there is anti-phishing, where we provide the protection from links, not just coming in from emails, but from any app like messaging or WhatsApp or even your regular browsing sessions. And please do note that all this is agnostic to the browser. Also, since we're talking about mobile, so there are all these apps on the device that are actually making connection behind the scenes, and it's the Defender app that ensures that there are no malicious connections being made, and if they are, we go ahead and block them. And finally, custom indicators. So all the good work that you've done for Windows, where you would allow a particular domain or block a certain URL, all those things can be carried over to mobile. So next comes malware scan, where it's malicious apps or a potentially unwanted application, or even like files being dropped onto the device. We scan all these. In addition to that, any storage is also covered. Then we come to single pane of glass. Now, seeing all these alerts, be it from phishing or malware, in a similar way as we do for Windows and Mac and Linux, where you can see the details associated with these alerts, like logged on user or active user or file details, etc. That is something that our customers value a lot. And what makes it even better is that the admin doesn't even have to make any connections. Everything is inbuilt. And then we come to conditional access, which formed a key part of the demo that you just saw, where essentially based on the risk that is there on the device and the compliance policies that you've set, the device can be marked as non-compliant. Now on the supported configurations, we support both the device administrator mode as well as Android Enterprise Work Profile. And finally on licensing, it's essentially part of the Defender for Endpoint license, covered under the 5 device rule.
Now over to the iOS demo, where we start with the anti-phishing scenario. Now the user here receives a malicious link in SMS, and when user clicks on it, we go ahead and issue a block on it because this was a malicious site. And here's the SecOps perspective, where you can see that the phishing attack has been blocked and all the details that are associated with it. Now over to the custom indicators demo, where again on the Defender portal, the admin has chosen to go ahead and block the gambling.com site, and that's what the admin is now committing to the system. So hence what we see is when an end user tries to access the same site on the device, she finds that it is blocked.
Let's come to the scope for the iOS public preview offering. Here the primary thing is web protection, which has anti-phishing capability from any source, that is email, messaging, browser, and it's agnostic to the browser, just like Android. Next, blocking unsafe network connections made by the apps in background. And finally, custom indicators that enable admins to allow block any URL or IP that we just saw. Next is the single pane of glass, just like we saw it Android. Then both supervised and unsupervised devices are supported. And just like Android, it is covered under Microsoft Defender for Endpoint license. So let's talk about the roadmap, starting with NAM. So currently we support only enrolled devices. We will allow MAM, that is unenrolled devices, after G. Next is A enhancements. So on Android Enterprise, currently our support is limited to work profile. Some customers have asked for support on the personal profile side or fully managed or dedicated modes, and we'll work on that post GA. Then comes web content filtering. On Windows, we've just come out with the web content filtering, which would enable enterprises to block links by categories like camping sites and all. And all this work will be extended to mobile as well. And on network protection front, we'll work on Wi-Fi protection. So coming to frequently asked questions, let's start with the most important one, that is licensing. So the easiest way to understand that is if you're licensed for Microsoft Defender for Endpoint, we cover you for Mac, Android, and iOS through the 5-device rule. So essentially what that means is if you're getting the license through either standalone Microsoft Defender for Endpoint license or N365 A5 or E5 license, or through our N365 security SKU, or as part of Windows A5 or E5, you will have access to these three endpoints. On Linux, the licensing is through the server SKU, which is available both for commercial and as well as for education customers. And your CSPs would have more details for pricing and eligibility requirements, and so would your accounting. And coming to other frequently asked questions, first one is about additional Linux distributions. So customer feedback will drive the expansion, and your account teams are the best set of folks to reach out to them with a request. Next one is support for unmanaged devices. So that's part of roadmap, and we will be working on it post GA. Then is Android Enterprise work profile supported? So yes, currently we support both the device administrator mode as well as the Android Enterprise work profile. And finally, how do you stay informed? Either like monitor our tech community blog or the what's new pages. And finally, we love feedback. So you would see the QR code as well as link for the survey. Please go ahead and provide feedback. It will be very, very valuable for us.
Thank you for spending time with us today. We're really happy to have you as our viewers.
And I hope you learned something new today. Thank you.
Thank you.